Hi, welcome to the class. So this is the last topic of this chapter, calorimetry, and the name of the topic is change of state or phase. So let me begin with this. Whenever we heat a substance, what this heat energy can do for us? This heat energy can do two things for us. Number one, it can bring a change in the temperature of the substance. Guys, keep one thing in mind that whenever this heat energy is bringing a change in the temperature of the substance, that time there will be no change in the state of the substance. Now state means we have three states, solid, liquid and gas. So whenever this temperature is increasing, no change in state. And the formula we have studied, Q is equals to mc delta T. The other thing which this heat energy can do is change the state of the substance. So it can convert solid to liquid or liquid to gas and so on. So here we have different types of processes in which solid will get converted into liquid, liquid will get converted into gas, and then reverse processes can also take place. As I told you that whenever this heat energy is bringing a change in temperature, there will be no change in state, and the same goes for change in state also. So whenever this heat energy is bringing a change in state, there will be no change in temperature. Okay. So when solid gets converted to liquid, it is known as melting. So we need heat energy to convert this solid into liquid, and this conversion takes place at constant temperature, because whenever there is a change in state, there will be no change in temperature. So this conversion of state takes place at constant temperature. Similarly, liquid to gas, vaporization, constant temperature. Gas to liquid, constant temperature. Liquid to solid, freezing, constant temperature. Gas directly to solid, solidification, constant temperature. And solid directly to gas, sublimation, at constant temperature. Now the amount of heat energy required to change the state. Now when I am saying heat energy required, suppose ice is getting converted to water, then heat is being absorbed. But when the reverse process takes place, that is water is being converted to ice, the heat is being given out. So this amount of heat energy which is either given out or which is either absorbed and is used to change the state of the substance at constant temperature is known as latent heat. So here we have this change in temperature, Q is equals to mc delta T. Change in state, it will take place at constant temperature. Like we have freezing point of ice, boiling point of water, and all these temperatures are constant. And the amount of heat energy which is being absorbed or which is being released in order to change the state of a substance at constant temperature is known as latent heat. So latent heat, definition already given to you. The amount of heat energy absorbed or released in order to change the state of a substance at constant temperature is known as latent heat. So now, moving ahead, I have here a very interesting graph to understand this change of state and the changing temperature for water. So let me plot this graph very quickly. So this is origin. Along this axis we have taken time, and along we will take temperature, and temperature will be in degrees Celsius. So let us say the water is at initially 20 degrees Celsius. So this is 20 degrees Celsius. We are assuming that the room temperature is 20 only, so water is at 20 degrees Celsius. Now water is being heated, so as the time increases, the temperature will increase, and up to a certain temperature, the water will increase, the temperature of the water will increase, and that temperature will be 100 degrees Celsius, because 100 degrees Celsius is the boiling point of water. And now at this particular temperature, the state of the water will change. Now the water will get converted into vapors. So when it is converting into vapors, that is boiling is taking place. 20, 40, you can put values randomly here. 100, 120, 140, 160, and like this. So when this boiling is taking place at 100 degrees Celsius. So heat has done two things for us. First, it has changed the temperature from here up till this point. So change in temperature is taking place, there is no change in state. When this boiling is taking place at constant temperature 100 degrees Celsius. Now no change in temperature, but the change in state is taking place. Now the heat energy which is there, which is going when state of the water is being changed, that time the amount of heat energy absorbed by the water at constant temperature, that is at 100 degrees Celsius, is known as the latent heat. Okay. So again, at a certain point when all of the water gets converted into steam or vapors, again the temperature will start rising. So this is an interesting graph to understand how the change of state of water is taking place. Now guys, a very important terminology, I hope this is clear to you, this change of state. So this was it in the change of state. Now let me start a topic. It is nothing but very simple topic, and this is specific latent heat. So as I told you, the definition of latent heat, this is something specific. So latent heat is the amount of heat energy absorbed or released when a change of state is taking place at a constant temperature. Specific latent heat is nothing but it involves the mass of the substance. That's it. It means for a given mass or unit mass, the amount of heat energy released or the amount of heat energy being absorbed at constant temperature to change the state of the substance. So unit mass will come. So the formula for this specific latent heat is Q is equals to ML, where L is the latent heat, not just latent heat, but it is a specific latent heat as it is talking about the mass of the substance. So L is equals to Q upon M, and the SI unit will be, this is joule, this is kg. So SI unit of L is joule per kg. So this is what you are supposed to remember. Now specific latent heat of fusion, again this is very easy to understand. Specific latent heat of fusion. Fusion means freezing. It means water, liquid is getting freezed into ice. So this is nothing but the same thing is used. You need to understand just two things. One, specific means for unit mass, and second, it has to take place at constant temperature because there is a change in the state of the substance. Now in case of ice, this L is 336120 joule per kg. It means ice has the highest specific latent heat of fusion, that is 336000 joule per kg. And now there are some consequences which I will talk in general very quickly, that because of the high specific latent heat of fusion for ice, ice is being used ice is being put up in the drinks in order to cool them. Why? Because it absorbs all the heat from that drink, and the drink we want to take up is being cooled because ice need this much joule of energy per kg of ice need this much joule of energy in order to change the state, and this will happen at constant temperature. So this was one. Second, whenever it snows, what happened after that? So why it is snowing, or the snow is the snow has happened, we are not going to feel that much cold. We are going to feel cold when it is melting. Why? Again, the snow is going to take up heat to melt from the surrounding. So when it takes a tremendous amount of heat, that is this much joule per kg of heat it is taking up from the environment in order to melt, and therefore we feel this coldness in the environment wherever the snow melts. So remember guys, specific latent heat is nothing, but it is for unit mass. SI unit is joule per kg, and the specific latent heat of fusion is the same thing. You need to understand that fusion is nothing but it is the freezing of ice and from liquid to solid form, and this takes place at constant temperature, and this is this much of joule of energy is required per kg of ice to melt. And what I also discussed the high specific latent heat of fusion of ice. Thank you.